G'day mates, Heartybbq here. We are time here. We are for pack, open, go, words. Let's not waste words. Let's open packs. And after we crack the pack, we're going to be talking about, if this was a draft, what I would be considering picking. First of all, we've got the Culling Drone, which is a 2-mana 2-2, which is pretty bad rate for this particular format. Sometimes the Ingest is relevant. If you're not actually connecting with this guy, if you're not dealing damage to your opponent and getting the Ingest, a 2-mana 2-2 is really doing you a disservice. Sometimes your curve needs it, and you need that 2-2 for 2-mana, just so that you're not overrun with things like McKinney Slide Runner. And that is a real thing. You want to make sure that every deck that you draft has an answer to McKinney Slide Runner, so you don't just die before turn 5. If that's the case, you need to take this guy, but you can do better. You can do much better. Seek the Wilds is not a card that I would really consider for limited. Again, McKinney Slide Runner, it's a common. It will roll you over and it will destroy you. If you are not curving out, if you're playing things like Seek the Wilds, I don't think that is a winning strategy on any given week. I would just steer well clear. I understand that sometimes you want to try and make, you know, all of those knee strategies go and work just fine, and sometimes you're going to be drafting sort of a four-color deck and going real deep. I understand, but Seek the Wilds is really, I mean, if you're playing Seek the Wilds, you are really opening yourself up to dying to all of those aggressive strategies that are pretty darn potent. Next up is Lithomancer's Focus. I like this. It's a 1-mana spell that you can use as a combat trick. 1 mana is not a lot to keep up, so you don't lose a lot by having it. Some decks it's not going to be that useful against. If you are playing against your opponent that's going to curve out and play out those Eldrazi, preventing the damage is pretty trivial text on this card. You don't want to have too many Lithomancer's Focus, but I do like one in a white aggressive deck. Next up is Goblin Warpaint. I haven't actually had the opportunity to make this tick. I think that you've got better strategies that you can work with in red. Either you're going to be in allies, perhaps red-white allies, or probably red-green landfall. And Goblin Warpaint isn't bad, but there's just so many ways for you to get blown out, because typically you're going to be putting Goblin Warpaint on something small. It does give haste, so potentially you could be playing something huge when you've got, you know, 9 mana. That could be a thing that's happening, but if that is a thing that's happening, Goblin Warpaint, not so exciting. I'm not sure that this card is really worth playing in this limited environment as it stands. Now, Natural Connection. This might be a little bit controversial. I think that any deck that is playing this is doing something wrong. You definitely do not need or want this for landfall. Honestly, for the landfall decks that I have run, and I have run successfully, just having a land is doing all that you need to do. See, the landfall guys, they just become so big. They don't need to be tricky. They don't need to be defensive. They just need to be hitting a land every turn. And you know what does that? Land. Land does it real great. Unless you are fixing your mana, and if you are fixing your mana, you're probably going a little bit deep, so I hope you've got some sort of insane rares and mythics that you are facilitating to make that splashing of extra colors worth it. And if you're not, I recommend you steer clear of things like Natural Connection. Tightening Coils. I am in love with Tightening Coils. This just does so many things so well in this format. It is very, very good. There is only a couple of cards. It's actually not many things that destroy enchantments that you're going to come across. You've got Felidar Cub, which is, you know, your 2-mana 2-2 white beta. That does it quite well. But other than that, man, Tightening Coils fixes so many problems. It solves so many issues for defensive decks. For aggressive decks, it's not so exciting, but there's so many insane bombs. Like, you know, your opponent plays a Drana, Tightening Coils. Your opponent plays an Eldrazi, Tightening Coils. It really saves your bacon so many times. It has to be in a defensive deck. If you're playing aggressively and your opponent, say, plays a 7-7 and you make it a 1-7, you're still not pushing through that 1-7 because that butt is so big and they get to block you all day long. But if you are defensive and if you're playing evasive guys, you're flying over the top. Tiny Girls is great. I don't want to be playing too many, probably, maybe just one. Maybe a second one in the sideboard at most of the time. But the first one I like so, so much. Eldrazi Devastator. So you have a whole host of Eldrazi to pick from. Eldrazi Devastator, I like this sort of third. I mean, Breaker of Armies is amazing. Ruin Processor is very good. And Eldrazi Devastator is, it's kind of okay. The Trample is okay. But I like those other, so Ruin Processor and Breaker of Armies much better. Breaker of Armies is fighting on the 8-drop slot. And how many 8-drops are you going to play? Not so many. I wouldn't be taking something like Eldrazi Devastator early, and I would hope to just get a better Eldrazi to play than this guy. Though if you do end up playing him, it's okay, I guess. Demon's Grasp. Being a sorcery hurts so much. It's sometimes a necessary evil. Being able to deal with things that have got 5 toughness is a real thing that you do want to be making use of. So necessary evil. I'm really not excited to be taking this. So I wouldn't be taking it early in a pack. Certainly not a first pick. That's not going to happen. Looming Spies. Very good. All of these lands, quite good. I'd be happy picking them up sort of middle of the pack. Same thing for Fertile Thicket, although probably more towards the end of the pack. It's not really doing all that much for you. So I'd probably put that much lower than Looming Spies, but still pretty reasonable. Herald of Kozilek is extremely strong. Doesn't take too much to really get value out of this guy. Already got reasonable stats. A 3-mana 2-4 is not too shabby already. If you are getting extra mana out of this, there aren't too many ways of efficiently ramping you. And this guy certainly is efficient. Pretty darn nice. So I'd be considering, he's in contention for a first pick. Blighted Step, pretty unexciting. I would be picking this sort of really late, really towards the end of a pack. But if it's not costing you on colors, it could be okay. Could be okay. Probably the lowest of all of the lands that you get value, the blighted lands and the coming into play lands. We've got the Deathless Behemoth. Now, I had a draft where it was completely head-scratching. Deathless Behemoth went, I took it sort of fourth last. That should not happen. This is a 6-mana 6/6 Vigilance. Read it again, a 6-mana 6/6 Vigilance. It also has some extra text on there as well. Even if you can't activate that extra text, a 6-mana 6/6 is so, so good. Pick it up. Don't let this go sort of fourth, fifth, last. This is really, really good. I can't think of a single deck that is not going to want a 6-drop. Even the aggressive ones. Even if you're playing red, black, aggressive, you're still going to get to 6 a lot of the time. Play this guy. It might be your top end. You might top out for a low curve aggressive deck. But every deck should be playing a card like this. Take it and take it early. This is in contention for first pick. I don't mind it at all. And it's colorless. It's colorless. How good is that for a first pick? A powerful colorless card. Commits you to nothing. Great, 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 great. Bring to Light. Yeah, don't play this in Limited. It might be wrecking the constructed arenas, but not for Limited. Just don't even bother. All right, and we have no expeditions there. So these were the considerations for the first pick. We had the Herald of Kozilek and the Deathless Behemoth, and I think this is a pretty darn easy pick. So we have the two-color card and the colorless card. Hey, it goes in aggressive decks, maybe just the top of the curve. It goes in defensive decks if you want to curve out and play big things. There you go. 6-mana 6/6 Vigilance, colorless, convince you to nothing. Great, great card. Very happy with that first pick. If you want to see the kind of decks that I am building in my Friday Night Drafts, I'm posting them on my Twitter at HardyBBQ. You can check them out on Twitter. More packs to come. Always more packs to come. These are the spoils of going 3-0 on my FNM Drafts, and I'm doing that quite a bit. So, look forward to the next pack opening, but until next time, thanks for watching.